Hi everybody, my name is Kate Berry from the University of Texas at Austin. And today I'm going to talk to you about counting up, which is an addition and subtraction fluency strategy that we use in Pirate Math Equation Quest. We have three interventions in Pirate Math Equation Quest, and we use counting up in all three interventions. We use counting up in the individual intervention with total difference and change schemas, the small group intervention with total difference, change, and equal group schemas, and the small group intervention for the Texas Word Problem Star Grade 3. Every lesson in Pirate Math Equation Quest has five components. We have Math Fact flashcards, Equation Quest, Buccaneer Problems, Ship Shape Sorting, and our Jolly Roger Review. We use counting up, addition, and subtraction during Math Fact flashcards, Buccaneer Problems, and the Jolly Roger Review. Students use counting up during Math Fact flashcards when they practice addition and subtraction fluency facts at the beginning of the lesson. We use counting up during the Buccaneer Problems when students and teachers work together to solve schema-based word problems. And lastly, we use counting up during our Jolly Roger Review when students independently work to solve addition and subtraction problems and word problems. Counting up has two parts. We have counting up addition and counting up subtraction. Before I model and demonstrate counting up addition and counting up subtraction, I want to talk to you a minute about the importance of fluency. Fluency is extremely important for students as they're entering elementary school. We recommend that teachers include fluency practice in their classrooms, and we want the fluency practice to be brief, and we want the fluency practice to be daily or frequent. In our program, Pirate Math Equation Quest, students meet with tutors 3 times a week. We use counting up, which is our fluency strategy, during every session for 1 to 2 minutes at the beginning of every session. When students build their fluency skills, every other aspect of math instruction becomes easier for them. So we really want to make sure that as teachers, we're embedding fluency into our math instruction. In fact, in our program, Pirate Math Equation Quest, students demonstrated improved fluency skills even though our program was specifically focused on word problems. So you can see that just 1 to 2 minutes every day really benefits students. Now let's practice using counting up addition with this Math Fact flashcard. This Math Fact flashcard reads 2 plus 5. So I'm going to use my 3 counting up steps to help me solve this problem. Step 1 says put the greater number in your fist and say it. Step 2 says count up the number that's less on your fingers. Step 3 says the sum is the last number you say. You'll notice on the poster that we have underlined the words greater, less, and sum. These words represent words that are formal math language. Students are going to be presented with formal math language words in class, on homework, on standardized tests. So we really, as teachers, want to be using these words in class so that the students are familiar with these words when we see them in other places. We don't want to say words like bigger or smaller because these words talk about quantities. Similarly, we do not want to use words like answer because this is an example of informal math language. Words like sum or difference are really going to prepare students for success. So let's take a look back at our Math Fact flashcard. It reads 2 plus 5. Step 1 says put the greater number in your fist and say it. When I look at 2 and 5, I see that 5 is the greater number. So I'm going to put 5 in my fist and say it. 5. I'm going to count up the number that's less on my fingers. The number that's less is 2. 5, 6, 7. The sum is the last number you say. The last number I said was 7, so our sum is 7. Let's do this problem all together. 1, 2, 3, really quickly. Let's do it. 5, 6, 7. The sum is 7. Let's try another addition Math Fact flashcard. This problem says 7 plus 4. I'm going to use my exact same steps to solve this problem. The first step says put the number that's greater in your fist and say it. When I look at 7 and 4, I see that 7 is greater. So I'm going to put 7 in my fist and say it like this. 7. Then I'm going to count up the number that's less, which is 4, on my fingers. Watch me. 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. The sum is the last number you say. The last number I said was 11, so our sum is 11. If we were to work this problem fluently, it would look like this. 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. Our sum is 11. Now let's look at a subtraction problem. We see 10 minus 4 over here. So we're going to use our counting up subtraction steps, which are just on the other side of our counting up addition steps, to solve this problem. Just like counting up addition, counting up subtraction has three steps. First, we're going to put the minus number in our fist and say it. Next, we're going to count up to the number you start with. And then we're going to figure out that the difference is going to be the number of fingers I have up. Again, notice I use difference instead of answer because difference is formal math language that we use to describe the answer in a subtraction problem. So let's take a look at step one. Step one says put the minus number in your fist and say it. The minus number is just the number that's directly after the minus sign. Here I see that here's the minus sign and 4 is directly after it. So 4 is our minus number. So I'm going to put 4 in my fist, 4, and then I'm going to count up to the number I start with. The number we start with is 10. So let's start at 4, which is our minus number, and count up to 10. Here we go. 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. The difference is the number of fingers I have up. I have 6 fingers up, so my difference is 6. If I were to do this problem fluently, following steps 1, 2, and 3 altogether, it would look like this. 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. The difference is 6. Let's try another counting up subtraction problem. Here, our problem says 9 minus 8. Again, I'm going to follow my three counting up subtraction steps. The first number that we see is a minus number here, 8. Our first step says put the minus number in your fist and say it. We know 8 is the minus number because it is the number that falls directly after the minus sign. I'm going to put 8 in my fist, 8. Then I'm going to count up to the number we start with. The number we start with is 9. So watch me, 8, 9. The difference is the number of fingers I have up. How many fingers do I have up? 1. Our difference is 1. If we were to complete this math fact flashcard fluently, it would look like this. 8, 9. My difference is 1. Thank you so much for taking this time to watch our video, Counting Up Addition and Subtraction. Hopefully now you can help your students to build their fluency skills. I would like to take this opportunity to thank IES, the University of Texas at Austin, and the Meadows Center for Preventing Educational Risk. Without their support, this research would not be possible. Thanks so much again for watching.